Maybe I'd be happy to let it all go and dedicate my life to making jelly molds. Learn to cook and learn to sew. I'm a happy homemaker.
Hi, and welcome to the Comfy Red Couch. My name is Tracy, and I'm your host, and I am coming to you from a very hot and humid Toronto. I am actually recording in the evening on Saturday night. Normally, I record on a Sunday just because it's the day that it is the most quiet, but Greg and Isaac have gone to the movies tonight. Nathaniel is upstairs having some quiet time, and I thought this was actually a pretty good time to podcast. Plus, we've got some lovely plans tomorrow that I am looking forward to just focusing on those plans, knowing that the podcast is already recorded, hopefully edited, and hopefully uploaded as well. I have gotten some knitting done this week. I've been on vacation the first week, and I always find this first week of holiday to be a real just jarring experience. I'm going full on, and then it's like a sudden stop. And this first week is usually a real adjustment, and I'm finding it being no different. It's been a bit of a challenge. I'm just now starting to wind down a bit, but I've been getting some knitting done and really just focusing on that knitting self-care that I need to do to get myself back to that full relaxation phase. Anyway, I do have some knitting that I'm going to share with you, but first I will tell you where you can find me. I am Tracy RR on Ravelry, and I am at Comfy Red Couch on Instagram. So if you'd like to drop me a line, you are always welcome to do so. If you are new to the podcast, this is a podcast that is primarily about knitting, although I do have something a little bit outside of knitting to share with you today, but usually it's the knitting. Welcome, and I hope that you have a chance to sit down and relax and that you enjoy the chatter that I get up to. If you are a returning viewer, you know I always love having you here, and I'm happy to have you jump up on the couch with me here. Tasha is at my feet. Scout is over on the floor trying to keep cool. The hardwood is much, much cooler than it is on the comfy red couch. And I do have to say, I've turned the fans off, so maybe the comfy red couch isn't the most comfortable at this point, but it's definitely more comfortable than, I think, sitting on the floor. Anyway, welcome, and I know you have your beverage of choice, you've got your project of choice, and you are ready to see what I've been up to, or see what you can see of what I've been up to this week. It is now time for tea time, and I have to admit, I actually have no idea which tea I am drinking right now. I just filled up a bunch of these with my cold brew filter, and it is probably one of the Bird and Blend iced teas. I know I just made some T2 of the watermelon sorbet, but I think this one is blueberry peach, so that's what I'm going to guess. Bird and Blend blueberry peach. And it is in my Liberty Swell bottle that I got from Starbucks for Christmas, not last year, but the year before. And a cold, refreshing cold brew tea is definitely what is in order in this hot Toronto. So I am wishing you a wonderful week ahead. I am wishing you lots of bits of cool. And I am wishing you lots of nice crafty time. So cheers to that. Yes, I think it is blueberry peach. This week I have 5 different projects that I would like to discuss with you. One of them is in a project bag. Yarn is all wound, but I'm still trying to muster up the courage, and that is my boxy sweater. So this is my gorgeous pink hazel bag with the London double-decker bus on it. I have my pattern. I have all my yarn wound up and ready. I just popped it in the bag that it came in. It is this gorgeous, the Shire. Oh, look at that green. It's so, so lovely. And these are the La Bien-Aimé Merino Singles. Got 4 skeins of those. I hope it's going to be enough. And I even have my needles at the ready. And in fact, earlier this week, I had purchased needles specifically for my Boxy, and I started another project that I'm going to share with you in a few minutes. And I realized that one of the needles that I had bought for my Boxy, I popped on that project. So while I was out yesterday, I picked up another needle specifically for my Boxy. So, project bag, needles, pattern, yarn. The only thing missing is my courage. And I started off knitting sweaters. So when I was a teenager, I'd knit sweaters. But now I am just a sweater knitting chicken. I am terrified that I'm going to do it wrong. I'm terrified that I'm going to have the wrong size. I'm terrified that so many different things. It's a commitment thing. It's just seriously a commitment thing. But my goal is to get my Boxy on the needles, if not next week, at some point. It is something I do want to work on while I am away in Cape Cod. But I've got to steel myself. Anyway, that is one project. It's ready. It's ready to go. I just got to get myself going on it. Anyway, so crossing my fingers that this is the week that it finally gets worked on. The next thing I am going to share with you is living in my surfer camper bag. And this is a test knit. I have shared the yarn with you before. I am halfway done now. And this is the gorgeous Nora George yarn, School's Out for Summer. And it is just so, so fun. It is knitting up like a dream, and I'm loving this pattern. I'm not sure when this will be released, but I know when it is, you are absolutely going to love this design. But for now, it lives in my bird leg bags, summer themed bag, and it is coming along really, really nicely. So, something to be put at the side. The next project that I'm going to share with you is living in my Grumpy Bear bag. Oh, Grumpy Bear is just too, too cute. And Grumpy Bear has had a project in him for a little bit of time. And this was a test knit that I did for the lovely Jules, who is So Sweet Violet. And this is the Mabel Socks pattern. And I knew when I took on this test knit that I would only be able to get one sock knit by the deadline. So I did that. And oh, these are just so adorable with the Mabel's cable up the side. And today, earlier today, I cast on the second sock. So this is what I did this morning and into this afternoon. Just worked on my lovely little beanie tote in the orange. And then this is Little Spruce as the main color for the sock. And then we've got some Mabel's cables happening up the side there. So for this project, I am using this orange mini. This is a Nora George mini, and I just, for the life of me, cannot remember what it was originally paired with. And this is a skein, and it's attached to a sock, so I better be careful, of Little Spruce. And this is also Nora George yarns, and this was in my Advent kit, I believe, for this year. And that was the lovely skein of yarn that came with the So Sweet Violet Advent kit this year. It is pouring with rain now, so that should definitely cool things down in Toronto. But yeah, just the skies have just recently opened and water is pouring down. Anyway, I did cast these on today and I am hoping to work on my second sock for the next few days, and hopefully next week I will have sock two done, and then I will have another completed finished object for 2019. So that will be a nice thing to have a second sock out of the way. Unless of course I leave the first sock here and then I have to find time to re-knit first sock. Let's put that first sock back in with Grumpy Bear. No wonder he's so grumpy, he's missing all his socks. The next project that I am going to share with you is going to be this one, and this is another Bird Leg Bags bag, and this is one I got from the Simply Sock Company, and it's got the little bauble on it, and it's just Pyrex dishes, and I felt like I'm on holiday now, I need to turn into my lovely happy homemaker self, and the Pyrex dish was going to do that. And this is a pattern that I am knitting for Isaac. This is the My Chrysalis shawl. And it is a pattern that I saw knit up in person. Someone at the Knitting Loft was wearing it. And I just thought it looked amazing. And had a very hard time getting it out of my mind. Plus, there was some brioche happening too, which I was just really feeling like I wanted some brioche. So I purchased this skein and this skein of Miss Bim, and this is Ching Fibers, and this is the Surrey Alpaca blend, and I'm trying to remember the name. It's very, very fluffy. When in doubt, it's melted Surrey. When in doubt, look at the yarn tag. So this is Melted Surrey. It is very, very fluffy. And this is in the Miss Bim colorway. And I decided that I was going to pair that with this gorgeous, also Ching Fibers. This is Merino Singles. And this is Sky Blue. And there's little pops of blue in the Melted Surrey. And when I held them side by side, I just thought they looked really great together. So that is the yarn I am using. And the My Chrysalis shawl, I woke up the other day and I really just felt like doing some brioche. So I wanted some brioche for breakfast. This project name is Brioche for Breakfast. And it did start off with the Melted Surrey in the Miss Bim. And then it went into this gorgeous eyelet striping section between the Miss Bim and the Sky Blue, and I am now finally getting some brioche in here, and then it will go back to the eyelet, and then there'll be some more brioche. But it is definitely very, very fluffy, and this will be a shawl that I am going to be giving to Isaac to take away to college with him, so he'll stay nice and warm when he goes from his residence to the campus. Well, he's on campus, but he has to go outside from the residence building to where he's doing the musical theater program. Anyway, I did get a little bit done on this, and I've got a couple more rows to do of the brioche, and then I'll be back to the eyelet. And yeah, it's been a nice, fairly relaxing project, and oh my goodness, it is so squishy and fluffy, and he likes these colors, so that's even better. Anyway, that is something that I wasn't expecting to throw on the needles, but I just really felt like that's what I wanted to do the other day. And as I said, I took the needles that I had purchased for my boxy, popped them on here, and then realized afterwards what I had done. So that's what happens with needles sometimes. Anyway, that will hopefully start to grow a little bit. And you know what? I think I'm going to do what I like to do with some of my different patterns. I have a lovely little blue dragon here. This is one of my Corner of Craft dragons. These are just so lovely and lightweight. I am going to pop this onto the project and let's see how far I get over the next week. So that is going back in the project bag for now. And hopefully I'll have a little bit of brioche for breakfast a few days this week. So that is that project there. I have one last project to share with you, and it's actually done. But I can't share the project, but I am going to share my yarn with you. This is a gorgeous Bags by Awesome Granny bag, and water themed. This is the Shawl Society season four, pattern three. I knew there was a three in there somewhere. And I'm going to share my yarn that I'm using. So Helen released the yarn that she is using for her sample, and mine is now off the needles. And I have chosen to use, it's a DK weight yarn, and I am using Julie Asselin Leitsu DK. And I've had these skeins of yarn in my stash for quite some time. So I was really quite pleased when I saw the pictures of Helen's shawl. I thought, I know what I want to use for that. So it was really good to know exactly. I had the yarn. I didn't have to go out and buy anything new for it. This is Thé d'après-midi, so afternoon tea. And it's this gorgeous light pinky purple, mauve, I suppose some people would say. The next color that I have used is berries. Petit fruit, so small berries, petit fruit. And then the last one, this one has been in my stash for a very long time. It was already caked up because I was going to use it for something else. And then I changed my mind that I was going to use it for something else. And again, I changed my mind. It finally got used. And this is Confiture. And it is just this gorgeous, rich, gorgeous purpley color. And it's so happily used now. Now, the interesting thing about this project was I went in thinking that this was going to be my A, this was going to be my B, and this was going to be my C. And that's the look that I really wanted for this shawl, was to have it go in this sort of knitting order. And I will tell you that, in fact, Helen has used her lightest color as her A, while I have used my medium color as my B. And it's very rare for me to have doubts when I'm knitting, once I've started about my color choices. But I was at about the 50% mark, and I was thinking I was going to finish it up, take some photographs, and then maybe frog it and re-knit, because I just wasn't, it wasn't quite coming out the way I thought it was. As I was knitting, I was really doubting myself. And as I said, I don't usually do that. But once I finally did get it off the needles, I was really quite pleased. And it did actually have the look that I was aiming for. But it shocked me a little bit. So what I would do is encourage you, when you see the pattern, you will want to definitely take a look at Helen's sample, which is gorgeous, and know that she's used her lightest color as her B. And then you may want to compare and see what the lightest color as A looks like. I think even the darkest color as the B yarn would be really, really interesting as well. So Depends on your colors. I think you're going to have fun with this one. It's a nice, relaxing knit. I did get it done fairly quickly, and as I said, it was just so lovely to be able to use this gorgeous stash yarn, and I cannot wait to share this with you. It will be released on July 18th, so not Thursday coming, but the one after. I'm not sure how I'm going to podcast that shawl, whether, because I will be going away. Usually on my podcasting day, I will be away that day, because that my normal podcasting day would be around the 20th or the 21st. And I will be away. So maybe I might do what I've done now, pre-record it, put it up as soon as the pattern's released, and then you'll have a chance to see it, or else you'll just have to look at photographs on Ravelry or Instagram. But for now, my third Shawl Society Season 4 is off the needles. It is blocked. I've taken a few photographs. I think I'd like to get a few more done. And I'm really liking how it turned out. I was surprised it was DK, especially for July. It's not something I would want to be wearing today. It's a little bit too warm for it, but it is a really, really nice shawl, and I do love my colors. Anyway, that is all. I have no more bags here left to share. 5 projects, that's what I got up to this week, and I'm hoping to bounce around a little bit, and as I said, I'm really hoping to get up my gumption to get this cast on, and Grumpy Bear is going to get some attention as well, and then there's a few other works in progress that I'd like to focus on this week, but it is nice to have the Shawl Society Shawl 3 done so that I can just focus on some selfish projects for a bit for the rest of this week. It's now time for brown paper packages, and my lovely mailman James Brown has been away this week, so I have really nothing of importance to share that was brought in through the mail. And the only thing that did arrive in the mail, you probably would not want me to share with you anyway, because it's all boys' underwear. That's what arrived in the mail this week. And I'm not going to share that with you because A, I don't really want to, and B, I'm pretty sure you don't want me to share that either. But I did make a trip out to UKnit yesterday, and I'm very excited to share what I picked up while I was there. And in fact, I actually pre-ordered because I was afraid it might sell out. UKnit is a lovely store in Toronto. It is on Bloor Street between Ossington and Christie stations. So Nathaniel and I jumped on the subway yesterday and went for a little jaunt out in the heat. And of course stopped at Tim Hortons on the way back because that's the perfect thing to do. And he had a lovely pink lemonade drink, and I had, of course, my black steep tea because that's my go-to at Tim Hortons. But before we went to Tim Hortons, we did go to UKnit, and UKnit, as I was saying, is a lovely store. It is half knitting and half sewing, and they have beautiful yarns, they have beautiful fabrics, they do some wonderful courses, and I was actually signed up to take a quilting course at UKnit last Saturday and today, but unfortunately it got postponed to today and next Saturday, and next Saturday I already have plans, so I had to cancel taking this quilting course. I've always wanted to take a quilting course, but it'll have to be another time. Anyway, I saw this amazing pattern on the weekly mail out, the email mail out that UKnit sends, and I had to buy it on the spot because it was just so adorable. But of course, I also had to go and look at some fabric while I was there. And I'm going to show you my fabric first. And it is this gorgeous denim color. So it's a chambray. It's denim color. And unfortunately, I don't think the neon bits are going to pick up. But there's little tiny neon bits. If you can think of the sock that has the little neps in it, this is sort of like that. It's got little, oh, there we go. I get a little bit of pink happening there, but there's like little neps, and they are neon colored, but it's more of a darker denim. There was a lighter version, and of course the neon pop showed off a little bit more so, and you might even be able to see them in the white fringe there. But I just thought this was really quite a cute fabric. And the pattern that I picked up was from a company I hadn't heard of before, and I think that unit is just starting to carry this. And this is a company called Sew House 7, and this is the Burnside Bibs pattern. And they are overalls, and they are absolutely adorable. And there's two different versions. There's one that has the rounded bib at the front, or there's one that actually has it squared off. And this version has a little bit of a side zip. It's a little bit more tailored, I think, than the straight bib one. But I'm sure you could mix and match as you wanted. But I saw this pattern and I thought, I love overalls. I have got to make this summer. So I picked up this gorgeous fabric and all I need to do is get to the sewing machine and, well, before I get to the sewing machine, maybe cut out the fabric first and then start sewing. So that is what I picked up at UKnit, and I was very tempted by some yarn there, but no, I just stuck with my pattern, some fabric, and of course I got some thread as well. And as I was there, I was thinking to myself, I'm forgetting something. And I just couldn't remember what it was. And then when I left, I realized I forgot to get the interfacing. So it might be a dangerous thing to go back and pick up some interfacing, because there are so many cute versions of this. And I was looking at the hashtags on Instagram of some of the different finished versions, and there is a pair of overalls that have been made into shorts in red, and they are so adorable. So I want to make lots and lots of these, because I love them. And I think I'm going to do the cropped leg version in this, more like a lightweight summer. And but it is something that I could certainly make a longer pair for the winter, and then I could wear a sweater over top. My boxy would look amazing over top of an overall type pattern with a bit of a heavier linen leg. But that is what I picked up at UKnit. And as I said, I'm not showing you the boys' underwear. And that will leave me with an empty bag, and that's probably enough to share this week. It's now time for Bits and Bobs, and this is my segment where I talk about anything and everything not necessarily knitting related. And it was just a week of adjustment. As I said, I always sort of feel, especially the first week of holiday, it's like hitting a brick wall. You'd think that would be the opposite, because I'm now able to relax, but it's like I'm go, and then finally catch that breath, and you're just not sure what to do with yourself. And that's sort of how I feel right now. I'm not quite sure. I'm not fully in that summer relaxation mode. I'm looking around me and seeing all the things that need to be done here. I'm looking at all the projects I want to do, all of my WIPs, all of these sewing projects that I keep picking up fabric for, and I just need to sit down at the machine. What I actually really need to do is I need to put a better chair upstairs in my sewing machine, in my sewing room, because the chair that I have at my sewing machine now, whenever I sit in it, I get such a bad pain in my back. Even if I just sit on it for like 5-10 minutes, I really notice that my back hurts. So I really need to switch out that chair, and I think that would definitely be helpful to getting in the sewing machine a little bit more often. As would it not being 90 something degrees Fahrenheit, 30 something degrees Celsius up on the third floor, because that's hot. So plans are to get some sewing done this summer. And oh, those overalls, Yes. Right now, they're stealing my focus. Anyway, all the things that I want to do, and of course, coming off of busy, busy, busy at work to, I just want to get it all done. But balance. I need to do the balance thing. Anyway, that is sort of how I've been feeling a little bit. As I said, I'm not quite fully relaxed, but I'm feeling off. My routine's been a bit disrupted and still trying to figure that out. But I will. We do have our trip to Cape Cod coming up in the next couple of weeks, and I think we're actually going to borrow my parents' trailer instead of using the tent that we normally do. We've got our car has the hookup, so we just have to get an attachment and then we should be able to tow their trailer. That will definitely make things a little bit more comfortable, especially if it's raining, but it does add a little bit more stress as well, because then you've got to worry about driving with a trailer towing behind that you're not used to. But anyway, that's a couple of weeks down the road. I am looking forward to just having some quiet time in Cape Cod. I have been watching the Sharktivity app, and oh my goodness, the past week there have been so many shark sightings. This morning there were two sharks and they're not that far off of the shore. They're like 30 meters. That's not so far off of the shore. So as I said, oceanside, I might dip my toe in. But it's too cold anyway. 68 degrees Fahrenheit for swimming in is just too chilly, chilly, chilly for me. I do like to walk out on the bay side when the tide goes out. You can walk out, you can be out far, far, and you're really up to maybe your knees or mid-thigh, and it feels a little bit safer out there, although there have been some great white shark sightings out in the bay, which doesn't usually happen as often. So, but I think walking out in the tide, it'll be okay. We always love the kettle ponds, which are the freshwater ponds in Cape Cod. And they're just so refreshing, clear water. And you can see this, sometimes you can see fish swimming around you, but definitely fresh water and just such a lovely, refreshing swim. So that's where we usually swim, is in the kettle ponds, and then we'll go and sit on the beach. And I am looking forward to that for sure. And just that de-stressing, bringing some knitting with me. I am thinking the boxy will come with me, and then maybe just a pair of plain vanilla socks. And then I think I'll try and bring one more project, though I'm not sure what that will be. This year I will get some car knitting time done as well. Last year I was the sole driver, so I knew that no car knitting was happening. And I think I took three projects with me and really only worked on two. So, and then I went to the yarn store and bought yarn for another project. It might be nice to bring that one along with me. Lots to figure out. Another thing that happened this week, last Sunday after I recorded the podcast, Greg and I went out for a Vespa ride, and we went to the Toronto beaches. Over here, not here, this is, so when I first started the podcast, we had the comfy red couch, and it was a red couch, and it had been here for a little bit, and I have to tell you, it was not as comfy as this couch. I have to admit it. So then one of my parents' friends, they were downsizing, and we were able to purchase this couch, and it really is a nice, comfortable couch, but it's not red. So I do sort of dress it up with this, and I also have, it's covered by a quilt during the week, and then when my company comes over for the podcast, I uncover the couch. But most of the time, there is a quilt on this couch protecting it because it is white. But over to my right is what we refer to as the dingy white couch. And, oh my goodness. I have boys. It's a dingy white couch. We've had this couch for over 20 years, and it's a really nice couch. It's comfortable as well, but it has had its day. And at this point, it's in rough shape. I'm embarrassed to share it with you, so I'm not going to. Anyway, so on Sunday night, Greg and I went to a store on the beaches, and I had seen these gorgeous red chairs. They're very simple. I do like red. And they were reasonably priced, and we picked up two red chairs. So we will get them in the next week and a bit. They are on order. And the dingy white couch is unfortunately, it's not even recoverable at this point. It's going to say goodbye, and we're going to have two new red chairs come in. And when they come in, I'll share them with you, but I'm not sharing the dingy white couch. Anyway, so it will still be the white couch here, but I'll have some gorgeous red chairs. And if I put a lamp over there, maybe I'll actually start knitting over there. It's just not as light there as it is here. Anyway, that is something that is going to be changing in the house in the next couple of weeks. A couple new pieces of furniture, which will be red. Oh, I do like my red. And it's a nice red. This is, pull it out. This blanket that I put on the couch is actually one of the baby blankets that I bought when I was expecting Nathaniel. And it's just this, and it's not showing up as nicely as I'd like it. It's just a nice, rich red. It's a merino wool blanket with the brown trim. And yes, I always pop it up on the couch when I do podcast. It's maybe a little bit, the new couches are a little bit darker than this. The really nice, rich red. So anyway, those will be coming in. Dingy white couch, it will be going out. I'm hoping to put a little table between the two chairs, A, to stop the fighting of the boys that usually happens, and B, to put a lamp on so that it's a little bit brighter over there, because it is a little bit darker over in that side of the room. So maybe it'll be a nice comfy spot to do some knitting once the light is there. But I really do like my spot on this couch. For the podcast, as I said, I am recording a little bit early so that I can attend a family do tomorrow. And as I said, my word is balance for the year. So recording a little bit early allows me to have that balance and enjoy some family fun time while also sharing with you some of the things that I will be working on and have been working on the past little while. I am thinking over the next few weeks that I will be taking some holidays, and that will of course change the podcast schedule a little bit. And last year I did, when I was home, I podcast, and when I was away, I was away. And I will maybe take some footage while I'm away, but there will be a few weeks where I do go in the summer without podcasting, and I will usually try and tell you a week in advance that I'm not going to be here. But balance means going with the flow, and that's what I'm going to definitely try and do this summer. So tonight felt like a good time to do the podcast. Go with the flow. Thank you so much for joining me on the podcast this week. I hope that you've had a chance to sit down and relax. I hope I didn't shock you too much by putting the podcast out a little bit earlier. I know that the lovely Jules is doing a daily vlog in July, and I did briefly think about doing that. But then I realized that that would take a lot of commitment, and I'm already having commitment issues casting on a sweater. So I thought, you know what, I really need to try and take it easy. And while I may pop in a little videos while I'm out and about and here and there over the summer into the regular podcast, like I did last year at Algonquin Park and while we were away in Cape Cod and also in Florida. But I think I'm just going to try and take each day as it comes, find that balance, work on the projects I feel like working on. Today it was Grumpy Bear. Tomorrow, who knows? Who knows? I'm going to have a bit of car knitting tomorrow, so Grumpy Bear may come with me, or maybe my camper vans. I'm sorry to say, but I don't think Boxy's going to come with me tomorrow. Soon, though. Soon. Anyway, I am wishing you a wonderful week ahead. I hope that your week is full of balance and lots of crafting time and just all the wonderful things that summer in the Northern Hemisphere or winter in the Southern Hemisphere has to offer. Anyway, I am wishing you a wonderful week ahead, and I will see you next week on the Comfy Red Couch. Okay, it's white with a red blanket, but you know, it's the Comfy Red Couch. Bye. I am upstairs battling with the computer, and I realized as I finally got into iMovie that this is episode 100. 100 episodes of the comfy whatever color couch it is, and wow, hard to believe. So a huge thank you for joining me for any of the episodes. All of the episodes, if you've tuned in, and thank you again. And I will be recording episode 101 next week. So, wow, 100 episodes. Again, huge thanks to you for tuning in.